قال المؤلف رحمه الله عن أبي رقية تميم بن أوس الدارية رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الدين النصيحة قلنا لمن؟ قال لله ولكتابه ولرسوله ولأئمة المسلمين وعامتهم رواه مسلم. From Abu Ruqayyah Tameem ibn Aus al-Dari radiallahu anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the deen is nasiha. We said to whom? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, to Allah, his book, his messenger, and to the leaders of the Muslims, and to the common folk. Recorded by Muslim.
Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Wa salli wa sallam ala ashraf al-anbiya wa al-mursaleen, Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. This hadith, hadith Abi Tamim, ad-Daree, very short hadith that has a lots of meaning. They asked Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he say, ad-deenu nasiha. Deen divided two. Its meaning in the Islam, deen, two kind of meaning has. One of them, deen, al-amal. Action or good deeds. Second meaning, al-jaza, reward. The deen amal, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, radaytu billahi rabban wa bil islami deenan. This is amal, worship. Second one, al-jaza. Jaza, that means reward, day of judgment. Malik yawm al-deen. The reward. So in this hadith, talking about al-amal, not day of judgment. Prophet Zasim said, ad-deen wa nasiha. In another narrator's come, ad-deen wa nasiha thalathan. The deen, advice, three times. That means he say ad-deenu nasiha, ad-deenu nasiha, ad-deenu nasiha. Three times he repeat. Sahaba, they wish to know what is this deen nasiha, as you want to know. They said for who? Nasiha, for who? Al-nasiha here meaning al-ikhlas, sincere. Nasiha here mean sincere. Ad-deenu nasiha, yani ad-deen al-ikhlas. The religion is ikhlas, sincere. The amal, we talk the ad-deen, we said amal, right? Al-ikhlas. If you don't have ikhlas, how you gonna? That's why, brother, if you don't study hadith with somebody, you will not know what is meaning a hadith. Just you read, you said deen and nasiha, that's mean advice. But what's advice meaning? That's mean here al-ikhlas. Ad-deen huna al-ikhlas. For who? For who should be sincere? Qulna liman. He said for who? We should be sincere. First thing he said, lillahi. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As you know, Allah will not accept your deeds except with two conditions. One of them, al-ikhlas, sincere. Second thing, al-mutaba'ah, following Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam without innovation. So al-ikhlas lillah, how is going to be? That's mean love Allah. That's mean following His order and be far away from is forbidden. He forbid you. Al-ikhlas like this. That's mean you have to defend on his sharia, defend on his kitab, defend on aqidah, asma' wa sifat. This is ikhlas. How are you going to be mukhlas? How are you going to be sincere? Like this. Al-dhabbu anillah. Al-dhab does mean defend. Al-dhab anillah wa an asma'. وصفاته والعقيدة الصحيحة وكتابه وشريعته وأوامره لابد مخلص تكون. You have to be مخلص for this book and himself and aqeedah, the creed and sharia, and follow what he said by sincere and be away from what he forbid. Ad-deen naseehah lillahi. First thing for Allah. Not if you don't study this hadith, what you will understand? That means you advise Allah. How are you gonna advise Allah? Sah? Wrong, you will understand. So that's why they said man kana sheikhu kitabu kana khatawa akthara min sawabih. Who his sheikh? Who his sheikh, his book, his mistake is gonna be more than correct. Why? Because you don't understand different than ulama understand. Different and ulama warathatul anbiya, ulama inheritors of prophets. So they take from the prophet and sahaba. So qulna liman qala lillah. This is number one. Second one, wali kitabi. You have to have a ikhlas to kitab. With the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sincere to Allah, with the reading, understand meaning, and practicing for ikhlas, da'wah ila Allah, ikhlas, da'wah ila Allah, da'wah to kitabihi, to his book, book of Allah, and tadabbur kitabihi, bil ikhlas, wa dhab an kitabihi, you defend on his book, and following his book, understand his book, li kitabihi, labudda tukum mukhlasan li kitabihi. كما أنك مخلصا لله كذلك مخلصا لكتابه. How you use them sincere for Allah, you have to have a sincere to his book. How you have to be sincere? Love, following, defend on his book, reading his book, memorize his book, understand his book, and follow what he ordered from his book. After the word he said, الدين نصيحة قلنا الإمام قال لله ولكتابه ولرسوله to his prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. How we have to be مخلص with the following. We have to have a sincere to follow. Second thing, love him with the ikhlas and defend on him with the ikhlas, defend on his deen with ikhlas. You have to have a ikhlas with everything. An-nasiha ikhlas lillahi walikitab walirasulih. You defend on him, following him, and defend on his sharia, Prophet ﷺ sharia, he brought it. Defend on his sunnah, defend on his wife, defend on his companion. This is from the ikhlas. هذا من الإخلاص. So if you don't defend on his deen, on his sharia, on his on himself, on his wife, on his companion, you will not be mukhlas. You will not be sincere for Prophet ﷺ. So you didn't follow الإخلاص النصيحة. قال لله ولكتابه ولرسوله ولأمة المسلمين. أئمة المسلمين, the leader of the Muslim. Leader of the Muslim, you have to know what is this leader. Leader divided to two. الأمراء ينقسمون إلى قسمين. Leader علماء, our leader علماء, and our leader ruler, who's ruling. How are you going to be mukhlas with the ulama? You have to be sincere. You love them. You love the ulama ahl sunnah, and you have to hate who's hating ulama ahl sunnah, and you have to follow what they said, and you have to not worship them, love them, and you have to defend on them sincere. And from the ikhlas, if they make mistake, you have to know, sure they did mistake. And from the ikhlas, you need to advise them in secret way. Though from the ikhlas, don't tell them from the people they did like this, they did like. Because from ulama Ahl Sunnah, they are human beings. They can make mistake. So you advise them and you don't mock them and you don't make a joke against them, because they are taken from the inheritance of Prophet ﷺ. Danger. So, because Allah said, أَطِيعُ اللَّهُ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولُ أُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ. You obey Allah and obey Messenger and your leaders too. Leader, we said, because this leader guided to deen, to akhirah, and this one guiding you to dunya. So two leaders we have. So you have to defend on them, defend on their knowledge, and you have to be advice for them sincere. If you make mistake, you can call them, you can talk to them with manners, with not show your muscle to them, with the manners and with a humble. I heard some cassette, you say like this, or some book you write like this, and we wanna make sure, did you say that, and what is this proof of? You need manners to have with a scholar. Because a scholar, they can make mistake, they are human beings, they are not malaika. So they are not prophet, they are not messenger. We are not saying ulama, they don't make mistake. Abu Hanifa, Malik, Shafi'i, Ahmad, all of them, they're Thawri, they make a mistake. Human beings they are. If they don't make mistake, that's mean we're gonna call them prophet, messenger. It's impossible.